Hello everyone, welcome back to Propedia. This channel is created to share with you in-depth research for projects all across Singapore. I'm Carissa. So for today, I'll be sharing on a project called Blossom Residences. It is an EC located in Bukit Panjang with 602 residential units ranging from 2 to 4 bedrooms. So this development has hit the 5-year MOP period in September 2019, which means that it is considered a semi-privatized condo that can only be sold to Singaporeans and permanent residences. And today, I'll be analyzing the 2-bedroom based on these two factors. First is the timing of exit. Second is the consumer behavior. So for Blossom Residences, there are only 32 units of 2 bedrooms. It is quite common that developers will not build many 2 bedrooms as the nature of EC caters towards more family and HDB upgraders. Hence, there's only one layout and one size of 753 square feet. It is located on 2 different stacks, stack 1 and stack 2. But do take note, there are some slight differences for the lowest and the highest level. Level 1 units are 1076 square feet for stack 1, 1109 square feet for stack 2, and the main size difference are on the patios. Whereas for level 16, it is 969 square feet where it comes with a balcony and a high ceiling. So for the first factor I'll be talking about is the timing of exit. As you can see here, the 2 bedrooms that make the least profit were mostly those that sold before the 5-year NOP period mark. And those which made the most profit were those that sold upon or after the MOP period. So prices peaked upon MOP because of 3 main reasons. First, there are new groups of buyers, which are the PRs and the single Singaporeans. This increases the demand of EC significantly. Single buyers are not eligible to purchase EC which have not met the 5-year MOP period because such ECs are still subjected to HDB rulings, which means that you have to form a family nucleus in order to make the purchase. So the second reason is that as more people look to sell, the projects will start to gain traction and in turn gain frequent transactions. And this will help to boost up the overall price in Blossom Residences. And the last reason is that something that most people overlook. So if you were to sell your EC before the 5-year MOP period, the buyer's financing will be limited based on MSR. This will affect the buyer's purchasing power and also further limit the number of resale buyers who are eligible to purchase your property. I will illustrate this using a case study based on the MSR calculation. So assuming a married couple, husband and wife, both 28 years old, earning a combined income of $5,000 with zero debt obligations. Let's say they are keen in a unit in Blossom Residences based on a resale price tag of $655,000. They will need to pay a down payment of $339,000, inclusive of stamp duty, as they are only able to loan up to $334,000. So versus a unit that has reached the MOP period with the same profile, let's say they are keen in a unit in Blossom Residences based on a resale price tag of $750,000, they will need to pay a down payment of $212,000 as they are able to loan up to $668,000 due to TDSR calculation. Hence, if they choose to buy before the MOP period of the EC, their loan eligibility will drop significantly to $334,000 due to MSR. This means that they need to make more down payment, which might be a stretch for most people. That is why most EC owners choose to sell after MOP. And of course, not forgetting the current market is in a bull run as new launch is depleting, which in turn helps to drive up the resale market. So the second factor that I'll be talking about is the consumer behavior. Although the profit margin of the 2-bedroom is considered very decent, but if you have to look at the top 20 most profitable transactions in Blossom, you will notice that it is all the big size units and that their profits range from $300,000 to $500,000. Yes, it is for sure that the bigger units will make more, but the point I'm trying to bring across is that Bukit Panjang is an old state area with many HDB, which also means that if I'm a HDB upgrader with a family of 4, I will have to look for a bigger space, which explains why the bigger units are of demand in this area. So in conclusion, my advice for existing 2-bedroom owners is that you can ride on the bullish market to cash out on your property and swap for something bigger, as 2-bedrooms might not be of demand in this area. That's all for my analysis for today. If you find my videos useful, do remember to like and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!